Assalamu alaikum, I'm Andri, and once again I am warmly welcoming you to my essential Islamic mysticism series of lectures and lessons. Today we shall make an introduction, a brief intro to a phenomenon that we call Sufism. And we all know, mostly from our readings and also from some of definitions that are not so favorite, that Sufism is the ascetic and mystical movement or stream within Islam that emerged and appeared at the very early stage of this religion's development, and also that subsequently took a wide variety of religious, artistic, doctrinal, devotional, institutional forms. So Sufism's internal variety, or even better, diversity, has produced an equally wide modes of its assessments by both insiders and outsiders. So my study here shall be focused on the phenomenon of Sufism itself, and also I shall try to make a kind of an attempt to recreate or to represent in its conceptualizations by some various actors with vastly different intellectual, intelligible and devotional agendas. And I do hope so, inshallah, that they will reveal a great deal, not just about Sufism, but also about human beings' religious and spiritual imagination and impact more generally. So what lies beyond this very imagination, this very enthusiasm, this very dedication does not concern us here at that moment. We shall leave it to believers and also to some theologians to explore and to appreciate. But this task today that I shall be trying to get involved with is to examine how Sufism initially has been appointed, has been imagined, and in the case of insiders, let me call these, let us say, orthodoxies or heterodoxies practiced based on this imagination and enthusiasm by various parties and also by various protagonists and actors since its inception up to the present days. My approach to this very puzzling and demanding subject is inspired mainly by Hayden White's mentioned statement about history, that history is always history for someone, as a product of imagining implementations of facts, and also main figures that were being cherished within the Islamic streaming. So this continual imagining, this continual and enthusiastic endeavors and emplotting of the historical vicissitudes of the ascetic and mystical movement in Islam, both by outsiders, both by insiders, really allows us to discover always new and always old, always ancient, fresh nuances, and always presented and perpetual, like eternal aspects pertaining to what we call Sufism. So the process of imagining and the process of making our enthusiasm about it is also a kind of a process of revealing of the changing cultural, of a changing social, aesthetic, poetic, philosophical assumptions, if you like, current in the societies, whose members seek to conceptualize and also to make a solid explanation of the phenomenon of Sufism and the actions and statements of its followers, and not only followers, of the seekers. I shall correct myself at this very point, because my aim is not to speak about or to followers. I am here to speak and to share with those who seek, with those who question, with those who intimate, with those who relate. So, there are many, many, many Orientalists among academics and among non-academics. There are many non-Muslim anthropologists, philosophers, who, in a way, unfortunately, inevitably impoverished our understanding and viewing of Sufism and also of Islam en général. So I shall be making a kind of, let me say, incompatible methodology and a kind of unusual goal in front of me, so to feed my discourse as much as I am able to, and consequently to make a kind of illuminating and far from being fanciful explanation of what Sufism really is and how men, which means both males and females, believers or non-believers, Muslims or non-Muslims, are able to penetrate and deal with this kind of very unique form of spirituality. So I shall be also, if you ask me, pushed to be a kind of a neutral observer in some of stages of my pointing and discussing. But nevertheless, I shall be really put into position to make a universal care lesson for the world, for the people who really want to know much more about Sufism and why Sufism was, through centuries, has been put aside or darkened by many, let us say, orthodox establishment figures within Islam. So my point of view here shall be not only academic, I do hope so, but also kind of a very passionate attempt to arrange events, to arrange statements, to arrange dates, to arrange protagonists, to arrange the greatest Sufi handbooks and perspectives, schools and philosophical views, and also to make a kind of a historical documentation about what Sufism is and how Sufism can be developed and also cherished and taken care within our millennia intellectual and spiritual context. So today I will have a lot of things to do, but this is kind of a very brief introduction about the history, first of all, and understanding of Sufism and about its starting point at the particular particular span of time, and also some of conceptualization that inevitably destruct our view and our understanding of what Islam truly is. And Sufism is, if you ask me, and I shall be corroborate this claim, a Cinderella of Islam, which means the very heart of Islam, and we cannot be discussing about Sufism without having into our perspective Quranic teachings as well, and also a philosophical aspect that Quran is as a holy book, as the book of the greatest secrets, as the book of creation and recreation, carries within and inside. So A kind of a repacking of Sufism is not a thing that interests me, because I'm not a kind of a person that shall be making rearrangements about other people's discourses, or I shall not be tempting to make my views within the European cultural idiom, which is something which is not interesting for this attempt of mine. But I shall be, as an independent scholar, as an argumentative scholar, make a kind of brief, defined, and classified, let me say, even trendy, so to speak, to better understand intellectual contexts and also conventions that were born within Sufism. So I shall be presenting Sufism on its own terms, and Sufism shall present his own face and also shall be backing his own ideas and shall be defending his own name. So there were, as you already know, countless Sufi teachers, countless Sufi shaykhs and disciples, and I shall be trying to make a kind of observation that will be a kind of trans-regional meta-narrative, let me say, modern view on Sufism and how its dynamic historicity developed and how it was composed from the very beginning. So whoever is interested in these courses about Islamic spiritual tradition that is marked greatly by Sufism is more than welcome to join me on my Buy Me a Coffee platform and also on my YouTube channel. So stay well, stay kind, and inshallah, see you soon.